Hello and welcome. My name is Leah Kopke. I'm a 3D motion design freelancer, and this is my 3D modeling podcast, Ambient 3D Animations. Today, we're going to talk a little bit about how to reduce your polygon count inside of Cinema 4D, and we'll run through all the settings of Polygon Reduction. It's a generator inside of Cinema 4D. Now, this generator does result in triangles, so in case if you need a model with all quads with fewer polygons, I'll also leave a link to the Remesh Tool tutorial below in the description so that you can learn more about that if that's what you're looking for. So let's go ahead and get started and show how this generator works inside of Cinema 4D. Here we are inside of Cinema 4D. Let's start off with showing where you can find this tool. You can find it if you hold a click right over here. You'll see Polygon Reduction. You'll also be able to find it if you go into our Create menu, Generators, and down to Polygon Reduction here. You'll see the other tool that I was talking about, the Remesh, is right above it. So they're both available there. And you can also use Shift-C to open up the commander to go search for Polygon Reduction, and there it is as well. So you can click on it here to add it into your Object Manager. You can also drag and drop this into your UI so that it's ready to go if you're going to be using this tool a lot. Now, to be able to show how all these settings work on something, we're going to need a 3D model. So if you have Maxon 1, you'll have access to 3D models in here. If you just do a quick search for people, you'll find all of these models here to work with. I'm going to click on this one for today as an example. So here it is. And she's pretty detailed. She actually is very high poly. If you click on garage shading lines, you'll see all of these little polygons, all these little edges, and it's a very dense mesh. Now, if we want to reduce the density of this mesh, for instance, if we're doing an architectural type render and we're going to have a ton of these models in there, we don't want that high polygon count to increase the memory and it all in all slow down our computer and slow down our rendering process. But if the camera is going to be far away in an architectural render, we don't really need her to be high poly. We only need her to be high poly if we're having the camera in really close to see these details. So in that instance, it makes sense to reduce it. So if we want to reduce the polygon count of this character, we just need to drag and drop this model into the polygon reduction. And from here, we'll have a few options. You can see that it's running the effect on it. It went pretty quick, but there's a bar that shows up in the lower left where you can see the process. And when it's finished, you'll see that the polygon count reduces. Now you have settings for this. You can, first of all, affect this reduction strength setting. Right now it's at 90%. If we increase this further, her polygon count will reduce even more. So we can take this pretty far. And this is where it started off at. So you're choosing the percentage that these polygons are reduced by. And as I adjust the slider, you'll see that these other options here, triangle count, vertex count, and remaining edges, all of those numbers are affected. So you can control these by any one of these settings. And it will adjust the other settings correlating to it because one affects the other. I like to use a slider though. I think it's the most straightforward and easy. But you can also type a number in here. There's additional options. Right now I want to talk about the preserve UV boundaries. So for those of you who might not be super familiar with UV mapping, I'm going to switch from the standard mode to the UV edit mode to help you visualize it a little bit more. If I click on this character, you'll see that there's these islands, and these islands are textured. So there's a texture applied to them. If I open up the material for her, you'll see right here, you'll see that there's this texture here, and it's making up the texture for her pants, for her shirt, for everything. It's all in here. And these are the polygons, and you could see that they line up with the pants and such. So these are called UV islands. And it's basically, if you were to lay these polygons flat on a surface to make up the texture, how would that look? And that's how the character's textured and Cinema 4D calculates it and such. But you'll notice that we're running into some errors with the texture as we reduce the polygon count. You'll notice that as I increase this pretty far, there's some distortions. You can see her hair isn't quite lined up, and her mouth is becoming a little bit distorted. Just the edges of the islands are starting to become a little bit distorted. So what helps prevent those little errors from happening is if you turn on Preserve UV Boundaries. And it'll recalculate once I click that. You can see that bar in the lower left as it recalculates. And now you can see that it is preserving the boundary between her face and her hair, because that's where one of those UV islands meet up together. And her face is far less distorted. Her lips look better. Her hair looks better. Her hands look better. So it's an excellent tool for complex UV wrapped type models. There's this additional option called Preserve 3D Boundaries. To show this, I want to use a sphere. So I'm actually going to go back into standard mode. And I'll just hold a click on here and drop in a sphere. Now this sphere, I'd like to change to be a hexahedron, just a different type of sphere. You can either click this button here or use the C hotkey to make the sphere editable. And once I do that, I can go into polygon mode and I can use our brush selection, make it a little larger with the right bracket key, click on this and delete it. I'll click a few more polygons and delete it. Now, if I were to drop this sphere into a polygon reduction, you'll see with the Preserve 3D Boundaries on, pretty much that shape is preserved, that hole inside the sphere. And that's what it's referring to. If I uncheck this Preserve 3D Boundaries, it becomes all distorted. So you get a little bit of control with this button over the holes in your mesh and how they look. This boundary reduction angle is very interesting. So if I just turn off the polygon reduction for a moment, you'll see that these edges here are made up of multiple polygons. Like you could say this edge here is made up of these three connected polygons. And they're almost collinear, but you can see there's a little bit of an angle there. So this boundary reduction angle is at what angle? Cinema 4D recognizes this as being collinear and something that it could make into one polygon, versus if it should preserve that this is made up of three individual polygons and if it should preserve that. So let me see if I can show this a little bit, turning back on the polygon reduction. So let's increase it. If you increase it too far, it becomes very distorted. So you can see at 46 degrees, those three polygons became one edge. If I decrease this back to one, which is the default, you can see that these edges are made up by more than one polygon. The more I increase it, the more likely they are to be made up of one. If I increase it too far, it becomes very distorted and it's no longer holding its form, because that boundary reduction angle is just so high. And this is what's being used to calculate how to preserve the 3D boundaries. So it's almost like the level of accuracy for keeping the shape of that hole exactly how it was as it started. So it's a pretty interesting tool. We have one more to go over, and that is reduced children combined. So the idea of this is, if I were to have two spheres in our scene, so I'll just duplicate that one that we had before. I'm going to move it over here. So now we have two spheres. If we were to put both of these spheres in the polygon reduction, you'll see that they're both being reduced. And if you turn on reduced children combined and you select this, it will recognize the children of the polygon reduction as one object. So as you increase this, it will reduce the polygon count for both together in one calculation instead of calculating them individually. Whereas if I have this turned off, it will calculate the polygon reduction for these as though they're two separate objects. It'll calculate this one and it'll calculate this one separately. And this is maybe a little bit more noticeable if you were to have one of the objects in the hierarchy be higher density. Like I just added in this a copy of this mesh here. If I choose reduce children combined and I turn this on, it's going to calculate. But you'll see the largest polygon reduction on this mesh just because it was the most dense, and it's reducing them all 91%, but it's reducing them like they're one object. So it's not taking reducing 91% maybe from the sphere or 91% from this sphere. It's the total of all of them together. All of the polygons are reduced by 91%. But you can tell that the most polygons are really coming out of this character here. If I turn this off, it's going to run that calculation again, but it will apply it to each one equally. Each one of these is equally reduced in polygon count by 91% as individual objects, instead of treating them all as one mesh. So that's what the setting does. You can keyframe the polygon reduction strength. So if you want to animate it, you can. So that just about wraps up all the settings for the polygon reduction tool inside of Cinema 4D. I hope you found that helpful. If you did, please hit like. If you'd like to learn more 3D modeling tools, please hit subscribe. I've so far covered the mesh tools. I've covered many of the generators here inside of Cinema 4D. I've also covered Pyro, all the settings for the Pyro emitter tag. So if that's something that interests you, I have a ton of episodes, and I'm sure that something will be useful to you in your workflow. And you can find them on my YouTube channel, Ambient 3D Animations. If you'd like to check that out, please hit subscribe. If you'd like to know when more videos come out, please ring the bell. And I hope to see you here next time on Ambient 3D Animations.